Planetary Parade is the alignment of 3 to 8 planets on the same side of the Sun. On the sky from Earth, we see them lined up more or less in a straight line across the sky. There can be situations where all of the planets in the solar system are lined up on one side of the Sun or another. We have 7 planets on June 3rd, Mercury, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. Not all of the planets are visible without a telescope, but many of them are. So in this particular planetary parade, it's likely that we'll be able to see Mercury, certainly Jupiter, Mars, and Saturn. Uranus and Neptune are also involved, but you would need a binoculars or a telescope to be able to see those 2 planets. And it should make a spectacular scene. We'll be able to see the alignment for a couple of days before and after. This isn't something that happens just on the one day. And if we miss it because of weather or other reasons, there's another event in late August and several predicted for 2025. Planets are generally slightly brighter than most of the stars on the sky. And one of the key characteristics of a planet is they don't sparkle like the stars do. They don't twinkle. Because stars are point sources and the planets have some sort of extended dimension on the sky. So they don't twinkle due to the atmospheric effects of the Earth. And this is the key distinguisher between stars and planets. Mars is an intriguing place. It looks very Earth-like, and it certainly is. It looks very similar to extreme desert regions on Earth. But it's quite hostile to life, certainly life to humans, and perhaps life as we know it. That is, it has an unbreathable atmosphere. It's very cold on average, and it has a thin atmosphere and a weak magnetic field, so there's very little protection from cosmic rays and radiation from outer space. And so in order for humans to survive on the surface, we would need oxygen, we would need protection against the cold, and we would need protection against the radiation coming in from outer space. Jupiter is a big planet. It's the largest planet in our solar system, and so there's a lot of gravity there. That gravity over time has attracted isolated moons that are wandering through the solar system, asteroids and bigger objects. And over time, it has also caused satellites that are in orbit around Jupiter to break up into smaller bodies and then be retained in orbit. So there are lots of moons, moonlets, and debris, if you will, that are trapped in the gravitational field of Jupiter. Jupiter isn't alone. The other large planets in the solar system, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune, also have large numbers of moons for exactly the same reason. Saturn has these fantastic, beautiful rings. It's unique in the solar system for having large rings. It's not unique for having rings. Many other planets in the solar system have rings that are just not as large and glorious and spectacular as Saturn. It's likely that the rings of Saturn, which are made up of debris, of ice and rock, small particles from pebble-sized on up to larger kind of meter-sized chunks of ice and rock, came from the destruction of 2 or more larger moons, satellites of Saturn, that collided and broke up, and through the influence of current satellites that orbit Saturn, that gravitational influence has retained these massive, big, elegant rings around Saturn. The rings of Saturn, however, are not a long-term feature. They won't last forever. So there'll be a point in the future, likely when Saturn won't have any rings, but that's far in the distant future. Most of the planets and most of the other components of the solar system, asteroids and comets and whatnot, all orbit the Sun in a plane, as we say. So they're all in that, very close to that plane, more or less lined up together, although there is some variation. Most of the planets are inclined to the plane by a couple of degrees. Comets and asteroids can have larger inclinations, but the vast majority of the components of the inner solar system, at least, are all lined up on that plane. And we see similar things in other so-called extrasolar planetary systems, where the planets are lined up in a plane on a disk. And this is because the gas cloud that forms the planets and their moons collapses into a disk that rotates around the star, and from them the planets form, and so they're all more or less in the disk. With all of the planets being in a similar plane, they line up much easier on the sky over time at various points in their orbit. So yes, the answer is yes, being in the same plane in the disk of the solar system makes it much easier for planetary alignment.